It begins in Bethlehem, a nativity rhyme for Christmas time, presented by St. George Maple Ridge. Narrated by Dylan and Roxanne, with photos from parishioners past and present. Hello, welcome to St. George's, to this, our interactive nativity service. It's great that you've been able to spend part of your Christmas with us. Thank you so much for taking time out to join us. We hope that wherever you are ready to interact with the service. There will be actions, and Dylan and Roxanne will take you through those as you go through. As we start, I'm going to invite you to sit quietly. This is the only time you have to sit quietly in the service. Sit quietly for a moment. And we're going to take a moment to pray before we begin. So, loving God, we thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ, being born into the world that we celebrate this year and every year at Christmas time. Emmanuel, God with us. Help us as we hear the story again or for the first time to hear it as though it was the first time we're hearing it. We pray that you would speak to us by your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, amen.
We have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains, and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strains. Gloria in excelsis Deo. Why your joyous strains prolong? What the gladsome tidings be, which inspire your heavenly song? Gloria in excelsis Deo. Bethlehem and see him whose birth the angels sing. Come adore on bended knee Christ the Lord, the newborn King. Gloria in excelsis Deo.
It begins in Bethlehem, a nativity rhyme for Christmas time. My name is Roxanne, and Dylan and I will be leading you through the Nativity story today. There's going to be lots of opportunity for you to join in, so listen really carefully. Our story begins with a woman called Mary. I'll read the verses, but before I do that, I want Dylan to teach us the actions.
All right, so here are the actions that go along with the chorus. Join in if you can from home. So the first to start is, God knocks down the proud and lifts up the meek and does mighty things for those who are weak, and blesses the ones whose service he seeks. So sing out his praise, he's amazing. Now let's all join together as we say the chorus once again.
God knocks, down, the
knocks
proud,
down the proud
and lifts up the
lifts
meek,
up the meek
and does mighty,
does mighty things
for those
who
are weak. And
blesses
the ones,
whose service,
he seeks. So
sing out his praise.
He's amazing.
He's amazing.
A woman called Mary was doing her chores when an angel arrived, but not through the doors. He simply appeared and she dropped to the floor. Hello, Mary, he said. God is with you. God is with me, she wondered. But what does that mean? What is this all about? Is it some kind of dream? The angel just smiled. Don't be scared. Please don't scream. God is happy with you and will bless you. Let's say the chorus
God
again.
Down the proud.
Down the proud.
The meek,
lifts up the meek,
and does mighty things for those who are weak, and blesses the ones whose service he seeks. So sing out his praise. He's amazing.
You'll soon have a baby, the angel went on, a quite special baby called Jesus, God's son, the heir of King David. He'll sit on his throne, and his kingdom will last forever. But how, Mary asked, I don't understand. I'm engaged to be wed, but he's not yet my man. Trust God, said the angel. He's got it all planned. His spirit will come upon you. Ready?
God knocks down the proud,
and
lifts up the
meek,
and does mighty things for those who are weak. And blesses the ones whose service he seeks. So sing out his praise. He's amazing.
He's amazing.
Joyful and triumphant, oh come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh come, let us adore him. Oh come, let Let us adore him. Oh,
Help us learn to give and serve no matter what the task.
Joseph comes next in our story. He is engaged to Mary, but has just found out that she is having a baby that is not his. There's a chorus for his poem too. And once again, I'd like you all to join in. Here are the actions. Joseph, don't worry. Joseph, don't weep. Lay down your head and go back to sleep. Mary's been faithful, her love strong and deep, and her baby is God's own son. So let's all join together as we say it once again.
Joseph, don't worry. Joseph, don't weep. Lay down your head and go back to sleep. Mary's faithful, her love strong and deep, and her baby is God's own.
All night Joseph tossed. All night Joseph turned. He just couldn't sleep. He'd only just learned that Mary was pregnant. What's more, she'd confirmed that the baby she bore was not his.
Joseph, don't worry. Joseph, don't weep.
Lay down your head.
And go back to sleep. Mary's been faithful.
Her love strong and deep.
And her baby is God's only son.
She told him this tale, an angelic visit, a son to be born by God's Holy Spirit. The more she went on, the less he believed it. He wanted to break their engagement. But just as sleep came, that angel appeared. Don't worry, he said, there's nothing to fear. I know that you're troubled, so you need to hear that Mary is telling the truth. The baby she bears is God's holy son. Call his name Jesus, for he is the one God promised to send to save everyone. Emmanuel, God is with us. He's the answer to all that the prophets have said, so keep your engagement, be glad and be wed. And when Joseph woke up, that's just what he did. He took Mary to be his wife.
Joseph, don't worry. Joseph, don't weep. Lay down your head and go back to sleep. Mary's been faithful, her love strong and deep, and her baby is God's own son.
Lord, help us be like Joseph, a man both kind and just. Help us listen when you speak. Teach us how to trust.
Then Mary and Joseph, her husband, went down to be counted by Caesar in Bethlehem town. There were no empty rooms for the couple to stay, so they stopped in a place where the animals lay. And there, in the hay, she gave birth to God's son and cuddled and cradled her small special one.
Shepherds quake at the sight. radiant beams from thy holy face. With the dawn of redeeming grace, Jesus, Lord, at thy birth. Jesus, Lord, at thy birth.
And now it's time for the shepherds and their angel visitors. So we're going to say another chorus, and it goes like this. Sing praise to God and give him glory. Celebrate his wondrous story of love and joy and peace to men, for it begins in Bethlehem. So let's say that all together again, once again. The chorus goes, sing praise to God and give him glory. Celebrate his wondrous story of love and joy and peace to men, for it begins in Bethlehem. Shepherds lying on a hill. The night was silent. All was still. They watched their flock of grazing sheep and tried hard not to fall asleep. When bright and white an angel came to light the night, a fiery flame. The shepherds trembled where they lay. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. Sing praise to God and give him glory. Celebrate his wondrous story of love and joy and peace to men, for it begins in Bethlehem."
The news is good, the news I bring, good news to make you leap and sing, good news for people everywhere, good news of joy for all to share, good news for God has kept his word and sent his Savior, Christ the Lord, the one who promised he would send, is born this day in Bethlehem. And this will be a sign for you. This is how you know it's true. You'll find a baby wrapped in cloth, sleeping in a cattle trough. Then the angel was joined by more, 6 and 12 and 24, and then to many more to number, a heaven choir loud as thunder. And so the angels left that place, just like they'd come without a trace, except for all they sang and said, which echoed in the shepherds' heads. Let's go to Bethlehem and see. The shepherds all as one agreed. They found the baby where he lay, asleep upon a bed of hay. They told them what the angel said. Then Mary smiled and raised her head, a secret hid there in her eyes, for she was not one bit surprised. So back they went to sheep and hill, no longer silent, hardly still, but singing loud like angels bright of all they had seen that night. Let us say the chorus all together.
Sing praise to God and give him glory. Celebrate his wondrous story of love and joy and peace to men, for it begins in Bethlehem.
Sing glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies, with angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Christ by highest heaven adored, Christ the everlasting Lord, that in time behold he come, offspring of the Virgin. In flesh the Godhead seen, hail incarnate deity, pleased as God of us to dwell, Jesus our Emmanuel. of peace. Hail the Son of righteousness. Light and life to all he brings. Risen with healing in his wings. Mild he lays his glory by. Born that we no more may die. Born to raise each child of earth. Born to give a second birth. Hark, the herald angels sing. Glory to the newborn King. Hark, the herald angels sing. Glory to the newborn King.
Thank you, Lord, for angels' songs that shout aloud. The Savior's birth. Show us how to live in the ways that sing again for peace on earth.
Because now it's time for time to pass. The Star Watchers are following their star. But it takes them time to get to Bethlehem, so they don't arrive the night the shepherds do. No, it's probably something like a year or more later when they knock on King Herod's door. So can you join in with the chorus? And here are the new actions for it. So the chorus goes like this. One hump, two humps, lumpity lump. The Star Watchers went with a bump and a thump. One hump, two humps, lumpity lump. The Star Watchers followed the star. And we're going to say it all together once again. Here we go.
Two humps. Two humps. Lumpity lump. The Star Watchers followed with a bump and a thump. One hump. Two humps. Lumpity lump. The Star Watchers followed the star.
The Star Watchers watched the stars go by, looking for secrets in the sky. And then they saw a special star away in the west, away off far. A king's been born, that's what it means, Judea's way, or so it seems. They climbed aboard their camely beasts and set off west from their homes back east.
One hump.
One hump.
Two humps.
Two humps.
Lumpity lump.
Lumpity lump.
The Star Watchers, with a bump and a thump.
And a thump.
One hump.
One hump.
Two humps.
Two humps.
Lumpity
lump. Lumpity lump.
The Star Watchers followed the star.
At last their journey came to an end. They parked their camels in Jerusalem. Then they went to Herod, king of the nation, to ask him for some information. O king, they asked, they were quite polite. Somewhere around here on this starry night, a brand new baby king abides. Can you tell us where this child resides? A worried look crossed Herod's face. He had no plans to be replaced. So he asked his priest if they could tell where this brand new baby king might dwell. The priest all answered straight away, Bethlehem is what the prophets say. Then Herod thought an evil thing. I think I might need to meet this king. Star Watchers, friends, King Herod smiled. In Bethlehem, you'll find the child. Would you tell me where you find him, please? The exact address would put my mind at ease. Herod, of course, told them a lie. He'd already planned for the child to die. When they found the child, that's what he'd do. So the Star Watchers left without a clue.
The shining star led them to the place, a simple house, not some fancy space. And when they saw the little boy, they gave him a pile of special toys. Presents, rather, fit for a king, a bunch of shiny golden things, a spice called myrrh, a sort of perfume, while smelly frankincense filled the room. Then, in the night, they had a dream that showed them Herod's evil scheme. So they never said where the boy's house lay, but went straight home by another way.
One hump.
One hump.
Two hump.
Two hump.
Lumpity
lump. Lumpity lump. Lump.
The star watchers went
with
a bump
and a
hump.
Hump.
Hump. One hump.
One hump.
Two humps.
Hump. Hump.
Lumpity lump.
Lumpity lump.
The star watchers followed the star.
Three kings of Orient are, bearing gifts we traverse afar, field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding. Crown him again, King forever, ceasing never, over us all to reign. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect line. Frankincense to offer have I, incense owns a deity nigh, prayer and praising, all men raising, worshiping God on high. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding. Bitter perfume breathes a life of gathering gloom, sorrowing, sighing, bleeding, dying, sealed in a stone cold tomb. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding. Behold him arise, King and God and sacrifice. Alleluia, alleluia, heaven and earth replies. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding.
Lord, help us be like star watchers, following your lead, looking for your guidance in every word and deed.
We've had a lovely time celebrating the Christmas story. We do it every year. We do it for a reason, and that's why this one last poem. So what is the point of angels and shepherds and camels and stars, you say? Is it just a nice story to tell the children to celebrate Christmas Day? It's not just a story. It's not just for kids. It's the hinge on which history swings, that Bethlehem baby grew into a man who challenged all powers and kings.
He taught us that love is better than hate, that serving beats being in charge. He showed us the value of each human life, the little as well as the large. And then, on a cross, he died for us, died to take all our wrongs away, and walked 3 days later right out of his tomb to turn death's dark night to day. And that is the good news the angels proclaimed, the heart of all Jesus would do. A new life for now, a new life forever. That's his Christmas present to you.
Thank you so much to everyone who has put so much time and effort into making this service happen, to everyone who sent in photographs and all those in life groups and children and families who recorded the videos. This has really been a celebration of our whole community this Christmas. As we look forward to next year, we'd love to see you at St. George's. At the moment, everything's online, so you'll be able to join us for any of our other Christmas services. If you missed the carol service, you can catch up. Midnight communion available from 8 o'clock Christmas Eve, and Christmas Day 10 o'clock live on Facebook. So a few options right now. Thanks again to everyone who took part. I'm going to say a blessing before we play you out with a final song. And this blessing is a prayer that goes out to you and your families and friends this Christmas. So let's pray. May the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you now and evermore. Amen.
Shining in the sky. Below in Bethlehem, the King is sleeping. Oh, what a glorious night! Oh, what a glorious night!
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
What's that?